Hello friends, in the series of the income tax cases, today we will discuss the case of Shri Shruti Parampara Gurukul versus income tax officer exemptions. This case has been reported in 101 ITR Tribunal, page number 598, and the matter has been decided by Bangalore ITAT, and the date of the judgment is 9th January 2023. Friends, this case is regarding the exemption application made by the institution under Section 80G. First of all, I want to discuss a provision which is in the form of Explanation 3 to Section 80G, which states that the charitable purpose does not include any purpose, the whole or substantially the whole of which is of a religious nature. Meaning thereby that if the institution is only for the religious purposes, then it cannot be termed as charitable. There can be a blend of two, charitable and religious. But if the institution is only for the religious purposes, then exemption under Section 80G cannot be granted to that institution. In this particular case, the main activity of the institution was to impart the education of Ved to the students who were living in the Gurukul with the family of the gurus. Like in the ancient time, we have seen that the students were teaching in the Gurukuls and the families of the whole gurus and all the elders were there to preach the students. The provisional registration was granted to the institution, but when the question of granting the regular registration came, the CIT exemption said that the main purpose of the institution is to impart the knowledge of the Vedas to the students, and the knowledge of the Vedas is directly related to the Hindu religion. That is why, according to him, the institution is wholly for the religious purposes and exemption under Section 80G cannot be granted to the institution. So, the assessee went to the ITAT for relief. The ITAT made very important points regarding the Hindu religion. First of all, it was the point of the ITAT that Hinduism is not a religion. Hinduism is a way of life. It is not a religion. This is the most important point which the ITAT said in this judgment. One important line which I want to mention for your reference, which the ITAT said in this judgment, is that there is no religion by name Hindu, and the name Hindu was given by the British authorities like while dispensing justice with reference to the inheritance, partition, marriage and other personal laws of the inhabitants of this nation who are not Muslims, Christians, Buddhists and Jains. In broader sense, you can say that the ITAT said that Hinduism is a way of life and not religion. The next point which the ITAT said, imparting the knowledge of the Vedas is not restricted to a particular religion. For example, the knowledge of Vedas can be taken by any religion, whether it is Muslims, whether it is Christians, or whether it is Buddhism, or the people who believe in the way of life of Hinduism. So, the point of CIT appeal that if the education of Vedas is granted, then it is termed as Hindu religion is not correct. So the ITAT gave relief to the institution and said that in this case, the main purpose of the institution was to grant the education to the society as a whole. It was not to a particular religion, and the assessee got its 80G registration through the ITAT. Friends, at the end of this video, once again, I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is श्री श्रुति परंपरा गुरुकुलम वर्सेस इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर एग्जम्पशंस एंड दिस केस हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड इन 101 आईटीआर ट्रिब्यूनल एट पेज नंबर 598. द डेट ऑफ द जजमेंट इज 9th जनवरी 2023. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स.